What's going on, gamers? Today, we are going to go over how to start an experimental Minecraft server with Apex. Before we get started, don't forget to like, subscribe, and click that notification bell to stay up to date on all future videos. Minecraft's 1.20 update is bound to come out soon, but if you're looking for a way to experience some of the changes before it's actually released, then snapshots are going to be your best friend. These are hidden changes in the files that give you a way to play with items and mobs that aren't actually released in the game yet, giving you chances to see what's to come, or even to experience things that might not make it into the final update. This is super easy to do in our panel, so you'll be jumping into 1.20 territory in no time. If you don't know, snapshots are specifically made for the Java edition of Minecraft. This means that players using this version will be able to start an experimental server, while everyone else on Bedrock has to enable the features differently. We will be covering both of these options, but we're going to be focusing more on the Java side. Head towards your Apex server panel and then scroll down to the game file section and look up snapshot 22W42A or a newer version up to 1.19.3. Continue to change the version and then choose to create a new world, and then you can restart the server. Wait for the server to load up completely and turn online, and then you're going to want to push stop to turn it offline again. Now that the server is running an experimental version, we have to configure and generate the world. In the server panel, find config files in the top left, and then select the server settings option. From here, you're going to want to scroll all the way down and then find the initial enabled pack setting. And in the text box, you're going to want to write vanilla, update 120, and bundle written out like this. Save those changes at the bottom of the page, and then choose the restart later option. And after that, click your server name at the top of the page to head back to the main panel. And then scroll down and find the world section and press change world. Enter a new name for your world, like experimental, and then when that's done, you can click change world and finally restart the server. Now just head to the Minecraft launcher and head to installations in the top, and to the far right, make sure to checkmark the snapshots option. Look for the version that matches your server, and if you don't see it, you're going to have to head to new installation at the top, where you can look for the version that matches your server. After that, all you have to do is press play, and this will download all of the needed files and automatically launch the game. If you're wanting to play with the 1.20 features on Bedrock, then you can use the preview version of Minecraft. This is a different instance of the game, meaning you have to install it onto your device. For Windows, you're going to want to head to the website that we will have linked below to start downloading the preview. If you're on an iOS system, then you're going to have to opt into their beta to gain access. This tends to be completely full, but sometimes they'll allow new players on the first of every month. If the server isn't starting up after switching to a snapshot or a new version, then the cause is probably the world. The only way for experimental features to become available is through a new world. So make sure you're generating a fresh map for this process, which you're going to have to do in the panel. This can also be caused by an incorrect format in the initial enabled pack settings. For example, missing a comma or a space can break the file's format and stop the server from starting. So make sure that you are formatting them correctly with a comma and space between each of them. If you can't find that initial enabled packs in the server settings, then your server might not be set up properly. Make sure the game file has snapshot 22W42A or later selected, and make sure the server has been reset at least one time before going and checking in the settings. If for some reason you're still not seeing it, enter into the FTP file access from the main panel. Next, find the server properties file and press edit, and then add the following line to the bottom. After that, save the changes, and then you can restart the server to load up all of the files. 1.20's release is probably coming sooner than we think, but since we're not exactly sure when, why not jump into the action early? Not only can you get a taste of what's coming, but you can say you experienced 1.20 before anyone else. That's all for this one, gamers. As always, I hope you have lots of fun.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more great content like this, then subscribe or click these videos. Until next time, gamers.